Welcome to Business World. I'm your host Siddharth, and today on our Road to Recovery series, we have Mr. Shashank Srivastav, Executive Director, Marketing and Sales from Maruti Suzuki. Welcome to the show, sir.
Thank you for having me, Siddharth.
We are also joined by Abhishek Banerjee, who is my editorial colleague from Business World. Yeah. So, Shashank sir, tell us, auto industry globally and in India has been going through a downturn for the past one and a half years. And now, COVID-19 situation, we had zero sales in April. So, how is the current situation for the industry and Maruti?
Yeah, so when you refer to the market situation prior to COVID, yes, you are right. Actually, the slowdown started sometime in July, August of 2018. And we, of course, felt the effect, the full effect only in 19-20 financial year. But the reason, because the wholesale kept happening, but the retail couldn't take place. So the stock at dealerships and the network went up. Later on, of course, the correction happened and we saw H1 was actually very bad, was like close to minus 26 or something for the industry. But it improved a little bit in Q3 of last year. Q3, Maruti was a little positive, as also in the month of Jan and Feb. But again, when we saw that it was like almost like in the recovery stage or, you know, coming back to sort of normal, then we saw this COVID thing. And obviously, it's been a big setback for the industry and I think generally for all industries. But fortunately, after about 52 days of this shutdown, we started the showroom operations were allowed under the guidelines of MHA from the 4th of this month. And so far, we have actually had almost like 1,300 outlets which are open already, and delivery of almost close to 4,000 vehicles already. So in that sense, we have made the beginning. The wheels of business, the wheels of retailers started moving at least. You know, people mentioned that there was zero sale in April. So it must be a really scary thing for the industry, which normally does about 290 to 80,000 vehicles every month. For it to be zero, it's like scary. But I think it is also, I say internally in our discussions, I say there is also this power of zero. The zero also has some power. It also has a lot of learning in many ways. And I think one prime thing about this lockdown and this zero retails, zero business in this period has been a change of perspective and looking at all our systems and processes with a fresh and a very detailed, very inquisitive way and questioning every aspect of business. And I think it has thrown up some very surprising improvement areas and we have been working on those and going forward, I think it is just possible that while there has been a short-term losses of business in this period, but I think long-term it could probably have made us even more stronger if we can come out of this situation as a strong organization and as a strong industry.
Talking about your dealership network, you said 1,300 dealership network is running. How are you ensuring that your dealership network is maintaining social distancing now? About enlightening your customers and all, about other things, about being as contactless as possible. What are the things that you have worked out and you can share with us?
Yeah, and so yeah, very pertinent question, because you know during the lockdown period, while we talked to all like I think almost 150,000 plus customers who were in the process of booking the car or who were in the process of taking delivery of the car in March, who couldn't take delivery because of this lockdown. So we actually had been in touch with them and two things emerged very clearly and I think you have mentioned both of them. First is there was this great fear or apprehension in consumer mind. Post the lockdown, is it safe for them to visit the dealership? Is it safe for them to take delivery of the car? That's not the top of the mind requirement at the moment. So that clearly came out in the survey. So what we did was that we alleviate these fears in the mind of the consumers. What we did was we made a standard operating process for dealers, SOP, where we said that unless you implement all of them, you will not be allowed to start again. Remember, we have a very strong regional and area office team. We have 39 offices, by the way, in smaller places. So there they have to do a check and a confirmation, either a video confirmation or a written confirmation that these SOPs have been adhered to. Only then the dealers are allowed to restart. On your point about how to inform consumers, because while you may be doing these SOPs, you may be implementing them, but so first step was in making the SOP, second was implementing them, third was to how to convey this to the consumer. So we have a campaign now going whereby we are telling the consumers, we have a digital campaign, and also now you will see on television about how our dealerships are very safe to visit. And we have gone beyond, our SOPs are beyond the government mandated guidelines of thermal screening or sanitization or social distancing. We have gone beyond. For example, in a showroom, you always have some cars parked inside as a display car. So every time a customer touches or goes into that car, we do a full sanitization of the car so that the next customer can be sure that that car is sanitized. Or when we do the delivery of the car, a similar process for test drive. Also, we are trying to be as contactless as possible in terms of documentation.
Now, post-COVID, companies will be actually cutting their budgets and optimizing their financials. So, do you think OEMs like Maruti would be pushing their marketing budgets, or would they be cutting it down?
Yeah, so I think logically there has to be a little cut, definitely. But remember that in the need for advertising and the need for promotion of products is the maximum in this period. It is not when the market is great that you do maximum this thing. Although there is always a saying that in good times people want to advertise and in bad times they have to advertise. You know, that's a common saying. So absolutely, I think there is a need to do a strong marketing. Only thing is, and I think you rightly mentioned and very correctly pointed out, that the way can be different now. And that way is different because the media habits of consumers may be changing. I'm told, for example, that rather than sports, now media is now, the genre of news is doing so well. Or the genre of GC is doing much better than in the past. So you may have those sort of things. The consumption of media on, also on the digital this thing, and even social media platforms is also pretty large now. So what you will see is the pattern of the distribution of spends in the media changing based on the media habits and of the changing media habit. But I think as far as budgets are concerned, there will not be drastic changes, drastic cuts may not be there. I think the budgets will be cut because of the overall, if the business itself is assumed to be less. But however, as far as marketing goes, as I said, it is required to spend money to be able to get out of this.
Sir, with the lockdown 4 being coming after 17th of May, and the Prime Minister has also announced a lot of 20 lakh crores, and Finance Minister is announcing on a daily basis. So, do you does the auto industry have any particular expectations from the government? Do you expect them to reduce the taxes to increase the demand or something?
So while we talk about the auto industry, government has to look at the entire economy, including people, the displaced people, the small scale industries, or the MSMEs, and so on and so forth. So, government is apprised of the situation, and I'm sure they will do whatever is the best for the economy. As far as the expectations are concerned, as you were saying, of the rate cuts or something, what we actually focus on what is in our control. Clearly, cutting of interest rate or some other swaps, etc., is not exactly in the control of it. So, what we do is we focus on what is under our control, and that is what we are trying to do. We are trying to be as much like, for example, financing of is a key element, we believe, in reviving vehicle demand. We are in talk with banks how to, you know, we believe that the health of the dealers and their profitability is very important. So we are in constant touch with them to see what and how possible ways we can help them. Maybe their cash flow seems to be the problem. So whatever is possible in our area, whatever is under our control is what we try to do.
Widely believe the small cars are going to gain unprecedented numbers. And I mean, and you are the you have the largest portfolio of small cars. We expect more small cars from Maruti going forward. If this is the trend that you are foreseeing.
Okay, so actually, the product plans are made with a time frame of 3 to 4 years down the line. So what is seen today is what was thought of 4 years back. So it's not as if we see a trend today and tomorrow onwards we start seeing it. So there is a lag between 36 to 48 months for products to be designed, developed and introduced in the market. So I don't think the long-term product plan is going to change just because of these couple of months or four. However, as far as trends go, and you mentioned about the small car, our expectation, and I must add a caveat that it's only been a very few days that we have had some sort of business in the last 2 months. So it's not a trend which we can define clearly, that we cannot definitively say that there is a trend such as this. However, logically, and also when we speak to the consumers and take consumer research and consumer feedback, it does appear, 4 or 5 things appear to have coming in the market. One is, I think we mentioned earlier, people will prefer personal transport over local, public transport. That seems to be clear. And that is coming because people are not very, people are actually apprehensive of the social distancing and apprehensive about the safety of health and so on and so forth. So that is a trend which we clearly saw even in China when they opened again after their lockdown. This trend was clearly visible. That is one. Second is, in times of stress in the market, we believe that consumers gravitate towards the more established and more reliable brands. That is, we have seen in the past whenever there has been stress in the market. Of course, this type of situation is unprecedented. However, we have seen stress in the markets at many times in the past. Every time it happened, people gravitated towards the more established and the more. Second. Third, yes, the small cars, I think people will trade downwards in their demand. So the upper end will probably start buying the middle segment, the lower segment, probably the used car and so on and so forth. So there is this transfer of demand downwards. So this transfer of demand is something which we have observed earlier also whenever there was a question of affordability. So this is the third trend we believe. Fourth, we believe the first time buyers might increase because the car is a discretionary purchase. Requires sentiments to be good. At this time, the car buying purely out of status may take a slight back seat, because people might buy car more for functionality, that they need to travel with, but they don't have a public transport because they don't want to use public transport. And finally, I think a trend that in the additional car buying, you will still have the small car being prevalent, because people who may buy the cars for their wives or their kids or their other family members, etc., because they don't want them to now travel in a public transport, may not go in straight away for a larger car, both for affordability point of view and also from the maneuverability point of view. Initial inquiry levels that we have noticed, there's a slight uptick in the small car hatches inquiries, but as I said, it's too early and it is not definitive. That caveat has to be there in any conclusion that we make based on this data for very few days.
Is there any difference in the consumer buying pattern or so? Because I've heard that many of the consumers are now looking for sanitizer slots inside the car, and they're also looking for various other safety and hygiene are the topmost priorities in buying a car.
You cannot really change a product. There is not something which is a basic change of product of sanitization or thing. But yes, the accessory part. Yes, like some consumers are demanding, for example, people who are working who use drivers, for example, and many people in the bigger cities use drivers. They're saying if there can be a plastic, partition or thick plastic, you can say. You see it in some countries in taxis, they have this partitioning. So some people have asked for that. And some people, as you said rightly, they say ki there has to be a sanitizer, quick sanitizer for the seats and for the steering and all the doorknobs, etc. So those are being like that is developed as accessory, which can be quickly, you know, be given to the consumer at the time of delivery, so that he's actually convinced that it's all sanitized, and that is whenever he uses a car, he at least has those accessories to make sure that there is a proper you know, safety standard to follow.
Okay. Sir, going forward, there will be a new normal. People might not be having too many meetings. People, there will be social distancing. There will be new accessories, as you said.
So there are many things which manufacturers are doing, and Maruti Suzuki is doing to be able to. Of course, the big thing is that you look at each process. You question every process because you know, it's a absolutely new perspective. It's a different game now. As you said, the new norm is totally different. So you start looking at your systems and processes with a different eye. So you look at it and say, "Acha," you question everything. So things which were holy will also be questioned. That why is this required? Why is this system required? Why do you want to do this? And all costs will also be questioned. So I think going forward, you will see changes in the whole selling system.
Sir, one last question from my side.
Yes.
Sir, we all have grown up with Maruti Suzuki. I'm from an army background, so my parents are from the army. So we always had a Maruti Suzuki, and even in motorsports, Maruti Suzuki is there, and defense, armed forces, everywhere Maruti Suzuki is there.
Iconic,
yes. So now we globally, there is Suzuki Jimny, and everybody in India is waiting for it. So do we actually see this product coming down to India somewhere in the future?
Yeah, so Siddharth, if you see if you remember in the Auto Expo, we displayed the Jimny, and there was this huge crowd which came, and you know, it obviously has all the trappings of a iconic product, you know, the Jimny absolutely. So we have taken a lot of feedback from consumers, and we are doing the study very closely. And as and when we make a sale plan for it, we will definitely inform what we are going to do, and when if at all we introduce the Jimny for the Indian market.
So do we see these EV product developments going on a slow track rather than being fast track? And if yes, can you shed some light on that, or the plans remain on track and there have been no changes? And if you also can talk about the EV Wagner, which was lined up by Maruti.
Yeah, so EV, that part of the testing vehicles which we have been speaking about. So we are looking at the test data. First time an EV vehicle will come. So we will have we have to carefully watch the test data to see what, if at all, any changes are required. Having said that, nothing to do with COVID, frankly, but EVs as such, and we have said earlier as well, that EVs are in the world a very small percentage of sales. Even today, it is about 1% to 1.25%. If you look at the world, there are countries like Norway or Netherlands which do much better, but I'm saying, and the reason is that the cost of the current battery technology makes it very unlikely for it to be priced in an affordable range for the consumer. One. Second, what also it requires a lot of infrastructure for charging, is currently not being solved in the Indian context. Third, there is a big range anxiety for the consumers. How long, and so you considering these factors make that market development of EV itself is small. It's remained small. So if you want to have a practical and a scalable sort of operations regarding EV, then you have to solve these issues also before you can actually go large scale. However, if we, and assume that now you cannot go large scale, and most analysts are saying that the EVs will be 7 to 8% in 2030. between here, 2020-2030, if you take a CAGR of 6-7% per year, then you will be making something like 70 million cars. 70 million cars in this 10 years. Out of which 63-64 million will be ICE engines. The internal combustion engines. Because it's 7-8%. What do you do with these? Because it's a large part. 65 million out of 70 million. So obviously, if emission is really the criteria or the thing, then definitely you need to bring down, you have to increase the fuel efficiency of these cars, ICE cars also. We believe the best method to do it is a mix, because it's not a 0-1 switch on, switch off from ICE to electric. They will be concurrently a long period when they are together. So in this period, you need to have alternate technologies for bringing the emissions down, because it's a vast majority, mind you, 65 million out of 70 million. We believe hybrid is a very practical sort of solution. Second, we also are looking at CNG, which is also a very low emission thing. And increasingly, the Indian government is actually being encouraging the use of CNG for fuel for automobiles, because not only is the emission low, it's also low on cost. So I think on these factors, it will be a mix as we go forward, and that will, I suppose, be the direction which we will be taking in the future as well.
Okay, so Make in India, we have come to Atmanirbhar, and like Maruti is being into Atmanirbhar for a very long time, right? But some components still come, especially from China and all, especially electronics and all. Do we see, Maruti, hand-holding its vendors and going up to making it sure that its vendors are also highly localizing their products? And if you're willing to share that.
That's
a signature quality.
Absolutely. Actually, ever since Maruti Suzuki has come into in the Indian auto industry, one of the thrust areas has always been localization. And that is how you see the great vendor base which has built up in the country. It didn't exist before that. So today we are exporting components and cars also across the world. So that has happened, and that's been a thrust area, not necessarily to do with this COVID thing or Atmanirbhar thing that you are mentioning, because it's always good. Localization does bring the cost down. It also protects you from currency fluctuations, etc., which is very important in this business. So that has been always been the thrust. But yes, there would be always, I suppose, in the globalized world, it is highly unlikely that 100% of the things will be, and I don't think that was intended to be meant when somebody said Atmanirbhar or anything. It didn't really mean that you have to cut off from the world. And I think we have seen a lot of people talking about Atmanirbhar doesn't really mean that you have to cut off from the world. So I think that part is quite clear. Localization has always been a thrust area. Mind you, many of the new products which we launch are launched with a very high level of localization, 90% plus, So that's been a strength of Maruti, actually. And that adds a great value to our products in terms of in the eyes of the consumer, because that makes our products so much more, giving more to the consumers in value terms. So that is what is the reason, and that thrust will continue.
Maruti holds 51% of the market. So going forward, the rest of the year, 2020, what do you see for the Indian auto industry in terms of labor, in terms of consumer sentiment, in terms of supply chain issues, in terms of sales? Where do you think the industry will go?
Yeah, so I think initial few months will be to try to get back to normal sort of operations, both on the supply side as well as on the demand side. Initially, I think the coming out of this COVID thing, the sentiment it would be a little suppressed depressed as far as consumers are concerned. But as I said, sentiments can change very fast, and that's what we are hoping. We must spread more positive thing and reassure the consumers about the safety standards which are currently being operated at the dealership and at the factory also. So hopefully over a period of time. But I must say that I'm not able to give you a definitive answer. And the reason is that there are so many uncertainties which are, we don't really know how this COVID thing will unravel as we go along. How long this social distancing thing will continue, whether it will be 3 months or 6 months or 9 months or the whole year. We don't really know about this labor movement, of how much of labor has moved and how much, that sort of thing. So there are so many uncertainties that it's so difficult. But one thing is sure, that we have to make a beginning. That beginning has been made. When we started off this discussion, we started off giving this information that, you know, the dealers are open again, and we started delivering cars. I think that will be the thrust, and we will take it as it comes, that we will have to make sure that we open as many outlets as possible, try to get as much consumers, you know, to make consumer-friendly sales process, including digitalization, or to give them what they want in terms of affordability for finance packages, for example, the financing part that we discussed about retail finance, and so on and so forth. Also for our dealers, partners, how to make their system more robust so that they are more profitable. And we have to look at cost structures and also revenue structures. Fortunately, for dealers in Maruti Suzuki, we have a very robust model where we get revenue not only from sales, but also service, accessories, spare parts, insurance, finance, and extended warranty, and the whole gamut of activity. How to make it even more robust will also be a key challenge. So I think that is what is going to be the story for the rest of the year 2020.